During the active storm season of 2024, incredible tornadoes seem to be making daily headlines.
Horses are getting scared.
Despite the high tornado count, the death toll has been surprisingly low. Of the 1,600 tornadoes counted so far this year, only 44 deaths have been reported. Perhaps a testament to our warning system and luck.
Big daddy.
The deadliest tornado this year, so far, was this EF3 tracking across North Texas at night.
Boom. Is that it?
Shrouded in rain, I could only catch glimpses of the indiscernible tornado in power flashes as it struck a neighborhood near Valley View, Texas.
Oh, it's close.
Manufactured and mobile homes were heavily damaged or demolished, and 7 lives were lost.
Okay, we're going. We're out of the way.
As terrifying as this unseen tornado was, it doesn't come close to the world's deadliest tornadoes. In this video, we explore the deadliest tornadoes in history, and you might be surprised that most of them didn't occur in the U.S. On Wednesday, March 18, 1925, a highly visible funnel appeared under a classic supercell thunderstorm at 1 p.m. near Moore Township, Missouri. Shortly after, the deadliest tornado in U.S. history would claim its first life. Town after leveled town would endure a horror unlike anything America had ever seen. After crossing into Illinois, the parent storm transitioned to a high precipitation mode, obscuring the intense tornado behind a curtain of rain while the strength and size of the tornado increased. With wind estimates perhaps in excess of 300 miles per hour, the tornado obliterated the numerous towns directly in its path while racing across the landscape at an average speed of 62 miles per hour. Entire rows of homes were leveled and swept away. Schools were devastated, railroad tracks were reportedly ripped from the ground, and sheets of iron were carried as far as 50 miles away. In rural areas, farmhouses were also leveled. Trees were debarked, and the tornado carved deep scours into the earth, indicating this tornado would have easily earned the highest intensity rating on today's enhanced Fujita scale, an EF5. Back in 1925, there was no technologies yet available to detect tornadoes, nor systems in place to warn the public. Even using the word tornado in forecasts and warnings was banned by the U.S. Weather Bureau at the time to prevent panic among the public. Many victims likely had little to no warning before the tornado struck. Between the obliterated town of Gorham and the highly devastated town of Murfreesboro, the mile-wide tornado sprinted to an incredible speed of 73 miles per hour, and for a long time it was recognized as the fastest tornado ever recorded. In its wake, large fires burned structures with trapped victims inside. Thousands were left without shelter or food, and looters raided the rubble. After 3 hours and 38 minutes of unspeakable horror, the tornado, or family of tornadoes, finally dissipated at 4:38 p.m. near Petersburg, Indiana. Along a 235-mile damage path, approximately 15,000 homes had been destroyed and 695 men, women, and children lost their lives. 100 years later, America still hasn't seen anything like that terrible Wednesday in March 1925. As horrific as the Tri-State Tornado was, it's not the deadliest tornado ever recorded. On April 26, 1989, a large, powerful tornado tracked through Bangladesh. According to the World Meteorological Organization, this tornado killed roughly 1,300 people and injured 12,000. According to the Bangladesh Observer, the devastation was so complete that barring some skeletons of trees, there were no signs of standing infrastructures. Bangladesh is no stranger to terrible tornadoes. In fact, 6 historic tornadoes occurring in Bangladesh are contenders for the top 10 deadliest tornadoes ever recorded. The United States has only 2 on that list. On April 11, 1964, a tornado killed an estimated 300 to 1,400. 7 villages were wiped out. In its wake, there was no trace of human habitation. 5 years later, on April 14th, 923 people were killed. Reports of horribly mutilated victims were the result of 2, possibly 3 tornadoes. It's not that Bangladesh has bigger, badder tornadoes than the U.S. A proportionate slice of Tornado Alley has significantly more tornadoes. But if a big bad tornado occurs, it would be much more likely to hit a heavily populated area in Bangladesh than in the United States. The dense population, absence of sophisticated warning system, and lack of tornado shelter able to withstand destructive winds make Bangladesh highly vulnerable to any tornadoes that occur. After another devastating tornado on April 17, 1973, almost all houses in 8 villages were leveled, leaving a death toll of 681. On April 1, 1977, 500 were killed. A spokesperson reported that the destruction was complete. Not a single dwelling nor tree was standing. And the list goes on. In the United States, from 1961 to 1998, there were 2,851 tornado-related fatalities. That's about 75 deaths per year. During those 38 years, Mississippi was the state with the most fatalities, totaling 314. Mississippi is roughly 82% the size of Bangladesh, but in that same time period, there were more than 7,273 reported deaths in Bangladesh, making it by far the deadliest place in the world for tornadoes. So, sweet dreams, Bangladesh. Besides currently being the deadliest tornado in the U.S., the Tri-State Tornado of 1925 is often cited as being the fastest moving tornado at 73 miles per hour. However, in 2014, a tornado terrorizing Nebraska shattered that record. If you'd like to watch how our scientific field operations team calculated that tornado's peak forward motion at 94.6 miles per hour, you can watch this next video. Till then, sweet dreams, everyone.